Somebody here needs a blessing. Against them.
And verse 6 simply says, so they set out and went from village to village, preaching the gospel and healing everywhere. Amen. I want to stop right there and use for a thought. Overcoming rejection. Overcoming rejection. Well, my brothers and sisters, I took the liberty of looking up the word rejection in the Webster's Dictionary, only to find out what I already knew or felt. All right. You see, the word rejection means for something or someone not to be accepted or wanted. Do I have witness? You see, the word rejection, you guys, means for someone or something not to be accepted and wanted. My brothers and sisters, have you ever felt like you were rejected before? Have you ever felt like you were trying to achieve something, but something or someone was hindering you or hitting on you? Now, if you are honest with yourself, it is hard trying to keep a smile on your face every time a door closes in your face. Come on, somebody. It's just hard. Have you ever tried to apply for a job, and they told you that you couldn't meet the minimum qualification, or they told you you were overqualified, amen, or have you ever tried to apply for a certain college, and they told you that you weren't accepted because you didn't have the right GPA? Oh, my brothers and sisters, have you ever been rejected? Trying to fit in with this certain crowd, or trying out for this certain basketball or football team, or this sorority or fraternity, or what about the lady trying out for the cheerleading squad? They told you that you were slightly overweight because you couldn't make it, or you couldn't form the pyramid just right. Mother boys, how you ever been rejected? Or if I still haven't hit home yet, what about when you was coding or you was dating and the person you wanted didn't want you, he didn't have interest in you, but he was liking you and someone else? My brother and sister, that is a form of rejection. Can I get a witness? Behalf of my son, being rejected isn't fun. When all those so-called friends are getting accepted into these fine schools and they are going on about their business and they all seem to be getting finding the right mate for marriage to have a family, but you can't even seem to get to have a man or woman look your way. That is a form of rejection. Sometimes, just sometimes, being rejected brings about some jealousy or some dislike in someone else. Just sometimes. Sometimes you may be jealous because somebody else is achieving or Lawrence can dunk and I can't dunk, so I'm a little jealous of him because I can't do what he do. That's a form of rejection. Yeah. Hello, somebody. Yeah. Or what about when you don't understand when you have a business proposal and it was rejected, or mama is doing more for my sister or brother than me, or why dad always showing him how to drive and not showing me how to drive, or why the ladies always running to this guy and not me like he's the only one in the room. I mean, I'm trying to help somebody. If anybody in the house that feels like I have ever just been rejected, yeah, Jay, that sometimes rejection has you to step out of character every now and then.
That's right.
Just every now and then.
Right.
If you aren't careful.
That's right.
Sometimes you may even wonder why you are even here. I'm talking to myself now.
All right.
Why will I ever get married? Will I ever have a family? Will I ever get a decent paying job? Will the choir ever accept me even though I can't sing like Monica or Brandy or Jamie Foxx or R. Kelly? Or will the choir ever accept me even though I can't play the piano like Ray Charles and John Legend and Smokey Norton? Dean Woods, rejection sometimes will bring about painful memories or sometimes bring about certain things when you're trying to accomplish. Look at your neighbor real quick and tell your neighbor that it's going to get better. It's going to get better. Rejection will get better. My brothers and sisters, I stop by to tell you that God tells us that he will be there when everyone else disowns us. For the scripture in Psalms 27:10, though the father and mother forsake me, the Lord will receive me. Even though your family may disown you at times, the Bible says that the Lord will receive me. How do you know that even God himself was rejected? It's in the Bible. Look at Numbers chapter 14 and verse 11. Then God said to Moses, how long will these people reject me? Talking about the Israelites. How long will these people reject me? And how long will they not believe in me with all the signs which I have performed among them? Now, after all these miracles that God Even in the New Testament, when Jesus showed up in the flesh, he was rejected. In John chapter 1, verse 10. Verse 10 says, and he was in the world, meaning Jesus.
Right.
And though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to which it was his own, but his people did not receive you. Oh, my brothers and sisters, if that's not rejection, I don't know what it is.
That's right.
Talk about overcoming rejection.
All right.
Some, Ms. Lisa, you know, rejection been going on ever since the beginning of time. If we go back to our scripture reading this morning in Luke, chapter 9, Jesus starts off telling his disciples, he gave them power and authority over all demons and to cure all diseases.
Right.
Now, even though Jesus equipped them to have dominion, he still knew that there were some people that still will reject him. Jesus already knew. Look at verse 4. He said, whatever house you enter, stay there until you leave that town. Which means there were some people who accepted God's word, who accepted the teaching from the disciples, but then there were others who still wouldn't receive God's word from the disciples.
Alright.
Come here. Look at verse 5. Real quickly, look at verse 5. Jesus knew that there would be people and other people because in verse 5 he said, if people do not welcome you, shake the dust off your feet when you leave their town as a testimony against them. Can I teach you something real quickly? Can I teach you? Listen. Jesus was trying to warn them. He was trying to give them a heads up. He said, don't lose your way. Don't get depressed. Don't get upset or angry. Don't lose any sleep or don't lose your appetite or don't gain any weight or lose any weight because these people don't want to accept you. He said, just brush it off or just sweep it up on the roof or just trample on their feet or just shake the dust out there and keep on going because there are other people in other towns who will accept God's teaching, who will accept God's message. Hello, somebody. Just shake it off. You see, brother, have you ever needed maintenance done on your car? And you had this friend that was going to fix your car. He didn't have it for a whole week. You parked this car in the same spot, went back and still there. And then you said, look, I ain't got time for this. You asked this man, why didn't he fix my car yet? He said, well, I'm going to get to it. Look, you like, I had my car been for a whole week. I'm going to go find somebody else because I'm getting tired of waiting on you because guess what? He said he ain't have time for it. Is that some form of rejection when you had your car there for a week and it still ain't been fixed? It's still been in the same place? Is that some type of rejection? You see, my brothers and sisters, rejection, like I said, will have you step out of character if you aren't careful. It will have you cursing. It will have you getting upset. It will have you putting some people in their place when you say you're a Christian because of rejection. I don't know about y'all, but I have been rejected many times before. I have been... Hello, somebody. Can I teach you something? What we have to learn as people is we have to learn how to not get discouraged because this man or this woman don't want you. You have to keep on living for God. You have to learn how when it's done to you that this is the kind of man I want. This is the kind of woman I want. Someone who doesn't mind working for the Lord. Somebody who isn't afraid of testifying and telling the world what God has done to them. What about a man that doesn't mind washing dishes or changing diapers or burning the cooking where even though he's trying to cook for you to surprise you? Or what about the women who doesn't mind ironing clothes every now and then or running his bath while cooking him some lunch and dinner? You see, this is the secret. Rejection. All you need to do is just keep pressing forward. Can't give up. When you feel like you can't get ahead of your door, just keep on closing. Just do what the Lord told his disciples in verse 5. And what he said in verse 5. Shake up. Just shake the dust off your feet and keep on moving. If Subway don't want to hire you, go to Sonic. If Sonic don't want to hire you, go to McDonald's.
lady or man rejected and just go on and find somebody else. Hey, police. All right. Amen. What a blessing it is. Amen. To be able to overcome for the world. Let it won't always receive you in such a way. But all you gotta do is just know that if God be for you, He's more than the whole world against you. That's the only way that you can overcome it. Amen. Amen. That's the only way. We ask that we would stand now. The doors of the church stand open.
Williams, he wants to acknowledge his call to ministry.
Amen. 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 Amen, Brother Lawrence. Amen. Brother Lawrence is asking, certainly, that we would certainly again pray again for him. Amen. Amen. We certainly again want to do that. Amen. Amen. We certainly again want to do that. All right. We will get Brother Rod up here, and then we'll do that for Rod. Amen. 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 What we will do is, I will need to speak with you. You come and we can certainly talk about your calling, and would like to, with your mom, and we can sit down and talk and see a particular time and hear about your confession and all of that. Amen. Your acknowledgement. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. What a wonderful thing it is.